Hello students, this is my video where I'm going to teach you how to convert fractions into decimals the easy way. And by the easy way, I mean that I want you to use a calculator, or you are able to use a calculator here, although there is a longer way to do it, which I will show you one example when I'm done showing you the easy way. But you can use a calculator to do this calculation of converting fractions into decimals. So just like you see on the screen here, taking a fraction, turning it into a decimal. And you notice that it says they're equal. So in other words, 1/2 equals 0.5. Okay, so we're going to start off by having you do all of these. I want you to take all of these fractions and convert them to decimals. Just kidding about that. No, I don't want you to do all that. But I'm going to show you 6 examples on this page, 6 examples on the next page, so you know how to do them. And it's very easy. It's just using the idea of division. You just take your numerator, divide it by your denominator. 24 divided by 25. When you take 24 divided by 25 in your calculator, okay, you get the answer of 0.96. So 24 over 25 equals 0.96. 24 25ths equals 0.96. All right, so then we're going to go down here. 9/10, 9 over 10. Take 9, divide it by 10. That equals 0.9. So 9/10 equals 0.9. 9/10 equals 9/10. 18 over 25. So you take 18, divide it by 25. 18/25, 18 divided by 25 is 0.72. So 18/25 equals 0.72. And again, it's very simple. Take your numerator, divide it by your denominator. Moving to the right-hand column, 31/40, or 31 over 40. 31 divided by 40 equals 0.775. All right. And then we go to our next one, 27/40. 27 over 40. Take 27, divide it by 40. You get 0.675. And again, it's just simple division. 27 divided by 40 equals 0.675. Moving on to the last one on this page, 7/20, 7 over 20. 7 divided by 20 equals 0.35. Okay, and again, it's very easy. We're just taking the numerator, dividing it by the denominator in each example. Looking at the next page. All right, so we have 37/40. 37 divided by 40, that equals 0.925. Okay, and again, simply 37 divided by 40. Going down, 4 over 20, 4/20. 4 divided by 20 equals 0.2. 4 divided by 20. 49/50. Take 49 divided by 50, your numerator divided by your denominator. That equals 0.98. All right, so 49/50 equals 0.98. 13/16, 13 over 16. 13 divided by 16 equals, this is a bit of a longer decimal, 0.81. 0.8125. So 13/16 equals 0.8125. 3/20, 3 over 20 equals 0.15. So 3 over 20 equals 0.15. 3 divided by 20. 25/20. Now, sometimes this is the first one we see where the numerator is bigger than the denominator. This is the first time you'll see that you won't have a zero in your whole number ones place. So 25 divided by 20 gives us an answer of 1.25. So that will happen when your numerator is bigger than or larger than your denominator. You'll end up with not a zero in the numbers place, you'll end up with a one or a two, or you might end up with any sort of number, but it won't be a zero. All right, so it's pretty easy, huh? Remember the steps, numerator divided by denominator. And I did say I was gonna show you one example of doing this the long way. So 24 divided by 25. So listen to what I said there, 24 divided by 25. So what we're gonna do is, okay, 24 divided by 25, you can also do this by long division, okay? So 24 divided by 25, okay? So you have a larger number being divided into a smaller number, because how many times does 25 go into 24? Zero times. It doesn't go in at all because 25 is larger than 24. So what we do is we put a decimal and we just add a zero here and we move the decimal up here. So now we're really thinking like we're kind of ignoring this decimal because we moved it up here, and now we're kind of thinking of it as, I'm going to use my highlighter here. We're kind of thinking of it as 25 dividing into 240. How many times will 25 divide into 240? All right, so 25 goes into 240. It goes into it nine times. Okay, because 9 times 25 equals 225. And then we would subtract 240 minus 225 is 15. And I'm kind of getting ahead of myself here. So we still have a number to divide into, but 25 won't go into 15. So we put in another zero, bring it down. 25 divided into 150. How many times will 25 go into 150? 6 times. So 25 divided into 24 equals 0.96. So that would be the long way to do it. And as you see, click up here, that's what we got here. 0.96 when we used our calculator, 0.96 when we did it the long way. So hopefully this video was helpful. I hope it was helpful for you. If you have any questions, catch up with me in Zoom or in Google Classroom.